Soldering is awesome! I cannot wait to teach you guys. We have to do a couple of things first. We have to talk about soldering irons and we have to talk about solder, but these are going to be super short videos, and let's get to it. When you're looking for a soldering iron, your main focus is probably going to be the cost. And they go anywhere from like $5 all the way up to a couple of hundred. And since you guys are newbies, like, go cheap. You know, you can find a really good soldering iron for less than 10 bucks. There are a couple of things to consider when you're looking for one, though. The first thing you want to look at is the tip. If you're going to be doing electronic soldering or fine detail, you're going to want this pencil tip. If you're going to be doing things like crafts and stained glass, you're going to want a chisel tip. And we're going to be covering both kinds of soldering later on. Now let's take a look at the handle. So you want to have something that has a really nice weight to it, especially if you can try it out in person. You're going to be holding it up here instead of down here because this is the barrel. It gets really hot. And if you can find something with a rubberized grip to it, like this one. When it comes to the temperature of your soldering iron, generally you're going to want to find something between like 350 to 450 degrees. It really depends on the kind of solder that you're going to be using, but you want it to melt. You don't want it to bubble and burn. So take that into consideration when you know what kind of solder you're going to buy. There are going to be a couple of other things you want to buy when you're buying your soldering iron, just so that you have them all at the same time. The first one is going to be a cellulose sponge. The reason that you're going to get that is because you're going to use it to clean off your soldering iron. They will have displays either online or in the store of like wire mesh cleaners or blocks or all of these other kinds of things. And really, you don't need to spend more than a couple of dollars, especially starting out. And a cellulose sponge is perfect. Just make sure it's damp and not like super moist when you're using it, because you want to clean off the sponge. You don't necessarily want to electrocute yourself. Then the other thing you're going to want to look for is a holder. Now you can find these relatively cheap. There are some really good ones on Amazon for like $5. You want to make sure that it's stable, it's easy to get your soldering iron in and out of, and that it's well weighted on the bottom and not going to tip over. There are some people that you will see that keep it in a coffee cup. And while that's great for them, I do not recommend it for you. I would not do that, especially if you have cats or rats or other small animals that walk across your desk, because it's just going to take once for them to tip it over and you have a disaster. So better safe than sorry. Okay, this was a super quick video. As promised, the next one we're going to talk about solder, and then we're going to be on to the main event where we're actually going to be soldering. If this video has been helpful, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't yet, subscribe. If you have a question, leave it in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next video. Okay, bye.